Good evening. A human tragedy in the most desperate of circumstances has unfolded in Texas, not far from the United States-Mexico border. Almost 50 migrants have been found dead in the back of a semi-trailer in sweltering conditions. 16 others, including several children, are tonight fighting for life.
San Antonio, Texas, hovering close to 40 degrees. Next to railway tracks, flashing lights, police. In the middle of it all, a truck. Inside, an unfolding tragedy.
At this time, we have processed approximately 46 bodies that have been triaged and tagged and declared deceased.
A cry for help alerted nearby workers who found the trailer doors open and around 60 men, women and children. Most of them had died. 16 people, including 4 children, were close to it, too weak to get themselves out.
The patients that we saw were hot to the touch. They were suffering from heat stroke, heat exhaustion, no signs of water in the vehicle.
San Antonio is around 250 kilometres from the Mexico border. 5 years ago, the same tragedy in the same city. 10 migrants died in a cramped and hot truck left parked outside a Walmart. And in England in 2019, 39 Vietnamese migrants were found dead in a lorry trailer in Essex. They died from suffocation and hypothermia. Back in Texas, shock at what has unfolded in their neighbourhood.
They were just looking for a better life.
These people come to San Antonio to, you know, to come and work. I mean, they really don't do nothing to nobody.
3 people have been taken into custody, but police aren't certain of their involvement. But the search is on for the truck's driver.
We had our canines out here going through the woods, and we may have to do that again tomorrow.
We're not supposed to open up a truck and see stacks of bodies in there. None of us come to work imagining that.
Crossing the US border is a journey of risk and hope. Tonight it's ended in one of the deadliest migration tragedies in US history. At least 2 of the survivors are from Guatemala.
So the plight of migrants seeking refuge is always a humanitarian crisis, but tonight we are dealing with a horrific human tragedy.
Lizzie Pearl, 9 News.